Gustav Holst is most well known for his orchestral epic The Planets, that has served as an inspiration for many, many film composers. If you're looking for a score to study that kind of has it all, this is an easy recommendation. It is such a monster that they could easily make multiple videos out of it, so let me know if that's something you would like to see. But in today's video, I want to focus on how Holst orchestrates transitions. Not transitions from section A to B, but rather from one sound color or instrumental group to another. What we often see in The Planets is that a melody or accompanying figure starts very low and moves up all the way to a higher register. And the odds are that the range of such a melody will not fit the range of one instrument. And when it does, then either the low or the high register would lose some of its power. So in today's video, I want to look at three examples of how Gustav Holst deals with this. In the second movement, Venus, at some point we have this beautiful cello line entering. And after the first statements, he starts changing things up. Looking at just the notes, the line starts lower and ends higher. And here Gustav runs into a problem. The B flat he wants to start his line on is not on the cello. To solve this problem, he starts the line in the double basses, moves it through the cellos, and finishes in the violas. And the way he does it is rather interesting. He uses a technique that is, or might unofficially be, called dovetailing. Now, when I looked this term up to use in this video, it turns out that this is a notion that originates from woodworking. In woodworking, dovetailing is a technique where two pieces of wood are cut in such a way that when they are joined, they overlap and create a very strong connection between two said pieces of wood. They are the source of many very satisfying YouTube videos where two pieces of wood are joined in such a way that they fit perfectly. Now, dovetailing in music works in kind of the same way. According to this one article I found that mentions it, dovetailing can be thought of as a method of connecting neighboring formal sections of a work, allowing smooth transitions through an overlap of preceding and subsequent musical material. In this section, we see that he starts the line in the double basses, overlaps it with the cellos, after which the basses drop out. The overlap then starts in the violas, after which the cellos drop. All in all, in this line, he has made a very smooth transition by dovetailing from the double basses to the violas. And since the string instruments are all part of the same family and therefore very similar in sound color, this is a very smooth transition from a low to a high register. If we compare this to woodworking, this is your simple DIY run-of-the-mill dovetailing at work. A slightly more advanced variation of this technique happens in the opening. Again, let's just look at the notes first. The ominous opening melody starts on a very low G. While the first statement of the motif is just low, from the second statement he starts building the theme in two ways. He starts adding notes to fill out the chord, and he starts a ladder movement with a jump up and a step down that keeps rising in the register. And in the end, the highest note he reaches is a D4. Now, having this melody in one instrument from the low G to the high D would be almost impossible. The high D is technically on the bassoon, but it's rather frill and squeaky and not really fit to carry such a warlike melody. To keep the melody in the same sort of sound, it is important to keep in mind the distinction between different instrumental families. There is, of course, woodwinds, brass and strings, but they can be divided even further. In the woodwinds, for example, you have the double reed instruments, oboes and bassoons, single reeds, clarinets and saxophones, and the flutes. These instruments are grouped that way because of a certain feature of the instrument. In this case, on what kind of reeds they blow, or not, as is the case with the flute. This feature also partially determines the sound the instrument produces, which is closely related to the other instruments in the same group. With this in mind, let's get back to this opening melody. Holst starts with the bassoons and the horns. He phases the horns out later, so I'm focusing on the bassoons in this case. While they are great for this low register, when we move up, they will start to sound frailer when the melody goes higher. While the woodwinds are harder to get a uniform sound out of, like with the string section we saw earlier, he uses the double reed group to keep the melody in a similar sort of sound. He first adds English horn and bass oboe on the higher notes, overlapping with the bassoons that we already have. And here the bass clarinet is added for extra low support as we build towards the climax. Next up, the oboes are added. Notice how the bassoons are still on the highest melody notes, going higher than the English horn, which is a traditional higher instrument. Only after this opening statement do the bassoons move down and do the English horn and bass oboe fill out the middle voices in between oboe and bassoon. The melody has now fully been taken over by the oboes, and they keep it until the final note of this melodic statement. And again, I think the clarinets here are added to add some body to the sound to make up for the horns that have been dropped to build towards the climax. The oboe, English horn, bass oboe, and bassoon are all part of the double reed family, so their sound is rather similar. By making clever use of the same instrument group, the double reeds, and overlapping their voices, does Holst make this transition from low to high another one that is very smooth by use of dovetailing. This dovetail, however, is more of an intricate Japanese one, which makes use of more advanced cuts in the wood. Towards the end of the second movement, Venus, we have a section with a lot of movement in 16th notes. These 16th notes are played continuously in the first harp and supported by a mixture of woodwinds. He starts off by having these notes be played in the first clarinet and bass clarinet, higher voice in the clarinet and lower voice in the bass clarinet. After two bars, the voices start alternating in different instruments. The higher voice is now played alternating between clarinet 1 and flute, and the lower voice between clarinet 2 and bass clarinet. The final two bars of this passage are played entirely by clarinet 1 and flute. But now clarinet 1 has the lower voice and the flute the higher. So in this section, the accompanying figure has been moved from bass clarinet and clarinet to flute and clarinet. Why he did this could have multiple reasons, but how he gets from one to the other is, you guessed it, again done by dovetailing. Instead of jumping from one into the next, he makes sure the material overlaps. He uses the middle two bars to alternate the different divisions, making the transition again a lot smoother. On top of that, using alternating flutes and clarinets in the middle part coincidentally gives the player some gaps to breathe, which is also not unimportant. Comparing this to woodworking is having two pieces of wood that connect nicely but have an additional middle beam in order to make the connection even stronger. So there you have it, that's how Gustav Holst uses dovetailing to transition between sound colors. If you're looking for some more guidance on how you can apply score studying to virtual orchestration, I suggest you watch this video. And if you would like to see more videos about the planets or any other classical music piece, let me know in the comments down below. In the meantime, I hope you liked this video. Thank you so much to my patrons for their continued support, and I will see you in the next one.